football, had all the chances, and then, you know, great, great little bit of play. Yeah, Pandev has been terrific. So exchanging passing with Stankovic, and what a great run by Castaños there. That's no fluke. He's been doing that with enormous regularity. He had a great finish to last season with Feyenoord. High regard for him, beating the keeper at the near post. Can we blame the keeper?
No, I don't think so. I think he hit it so early, and he's kind of bent it round the goalkeeper. Yes, he's got beaten in the near post, but I think the pace of the ball, I don't think many keepers would save that.
Pulling off save after save.
Yeah, Katsalazi, he was brought in to work really, really hard. Fantastic diagonal wonderful ball from Mulgrew. And for the first time, Samaras challenging on the back shoulder. Gets a good contact, and that's a terrific save.
That's a world-class save. Dives forward, and this is a calamity of errors here for Inter Milan. But again, we talked about strikers. Do you think Samaras was sharp and effective?
He was on his heels. He wasn't anticipating, you know, from the first shot. The first shot is a very, very good save. And the second one, Mulgrew, if they'd have been on his left foot, he'd have broke the net with it, off balance with his right.
Early in the game, when Celi put a few tackles in. And, of course, closing down, that's the trademark of Inter Milan, closing down, but they obviously got too tight there.
Absolutely no chance of getting the ball back, has he? And then we see here as well, you know, that is a yellow card. Definitely two yellows. Referee's got it right, whether it's pre-season or not. He's trying to leave a bit on Scott Brown, and Scott Brown being Scott Brown, watch him pat him on the chest there, say, well done, mate, I've done my job, you were down even harder.
But they didn't make the advantage count, because moments later, they were 2-0 down. Yeah, what about the goalkeeper here, Pat?
Yeah. He should have been out. He should have been standing on his penalty spot, coming, taking that ball just right on the edge of the box. He hesitated, and of course, it's a good finish by the striker.
If you're going to play a high line like that, Chievu gets his head up, no pressure on the ball. Your starting position's got to be 10 yards further forward. That's travelled 70 yards, and he only had to move 5 yards to it.